Diego Gonzalez will kick off for Colorado. He's had 14 kickoffs this year. 13 of them have been touchbacks. J.U. Chesson and Jabril Peppers back deep for Michigan. Gonzalez ready. And we're underway. Peppers, 4 yards deep. Here he comes. Peppers with great speed. Can he get the corner? And out of bounds across the 25-yard line. Jabril Peppers, a 26-yard return, chased out by Ryan Moeller. And here comes Wilton Spate. What a start to the season. And last week, what a start period. 312 yards, 4 touchdowns, the Big Ten Offensive Player of the Week.
And he's getting a lot of help from those wide receivers. And don't forget Jake Butt. But Wilton Spate has answered the bell. And what I like about him, just talking to him, great confidence. He knows the position he's in, knows his job.
There's Butt in motion on first down. Davion Smith the carry. And Smith with a little move and gets the first down. Good start for a running game that's had its fits and starts as Smith gets the first down.
I think two things right here. For Michigan, they have to establish the running game. The first two games, they've not seen a real Michigan-like running game. And then I also think for Colorado, the Buffaloes, they have to be able to get out of the first quarter in good shape. And by that, I mean, you can temper the scoring and get on the board themselves.
On first down, Spate to the air for the first time. To the sideline, and that one is dropped by Amara Darbo. Don't see that very often from Darbo.
Yeah, you don't. He has been a guy who's, and this is right in his hands. This is completely on him. The ball was right where it needed to be. Sets up a second and long.
And Spate is out of the game. Shane Morris in now at quarterback. Jabril Peppers is in the backfield. The toss to Peppers. Peppers behind a couple of blockers, and Peppers is down. They'll mark him down at the 45. Akello Witherspoon off the stop, a 7-yard gain. So we saw Shane Morris, we saw Jabril Peppers. Was he down here? He thought he wasn't, and he tried to keep running.
Yeah, he kept on going, but just watch the athleticism and this kinesthetic sense. You can't see on the backside, but his elbow may have been the thing that put him down. You know, we were just talking last night about why are they going to put him on offense, because we hadn't seen it, and there's your answer.
Third down and three. Spate back in now at quarterback. Pressure coming from Colorado. Spate in some trouble, gets rid of it, almost intercepted. Tedrick Thompson was in the area, the pressure hot and heavy on Wilton Spate, and Colorado's defense gets the stop.
And that's exactly what Colorado needed to do. First, they have to be able to get pressure on the quarterback, which they were able to do and collapse that pocket. And because of that, he was able to throw incomplete. So the first series, they needed to get off the field without giving up any kind of big plays, and that's successful.
Kenny Allen will punt it away. McIntyre back, line drive punt at the 20. McIntyre, nice move, found a crease, and McIntyre near midfield before he's tracked down. Good return for McIntyre.
Now this is just using your eyes, and he's got good quickness, finds that crease and just gets up inside. Really well done by McIntyre. Had some help along the way with some blocks coming back, but pretty much that's on him.
36-yard punt, a 32-yard return, a net of 4 yards, and here comes Sefo Lufau. Look at the numbers this year through two games, not only through the air, but on the ground. He's a mobile quarterback that'll cause you problems.
They're going to have success today. Sefo Lufau is going to have to play his best game.
Donovan Lee takes the direct snap, a little end around to McIntyre, who will throw to Lufau. It's a first down and more to the Michigan 35-yard line. Ryan Glasgow back there on the stop. But a trick play to start for Colorado on the road.
What they want to do is try to get Michigan on their heels, so you start to guess. And there's no better way to do that than what they just did.
First down at the 35. Lufau on the toss to Lindsey. Nowhere to go. Jabril Peppers needs no trickery to blow that play up.
Well, For those of you who don't know about Jabril Peppers, after you get out from under that rock, you need to understand this is probably the best defensive player in the nation. He plays multiple positions, has a great amount of skill in every one of them.
Second and 13. Play action. Lufau with time, looking deep for the end zone. Touchdown! Devin Ross gets Colorado on the board first.
Exactly what Colorado needed. They needed to stop him on the first series, and they needed points. They want to serve notice. Keep in mind, this team doesn't know how good they are, and it's a pretty talented group. That right there was a huge boost of confidence for this Buffalo team.
Diego Gonzalez for the extra point. He's hit 47 straight extra points, make it 48 as Gonzalez pumps that one through, and a 7-0 lead for Colorado.
Well, you're Devin Ross, you're on the back end. All you do is get on top of that coverage. You've got to be able to get to the middle of the field. No one was there. He did all the above.
Opponents 87-0, and here's how they scored once more.
So I want you to see what Ross is seeing. See, Ross is lined up, and he knows that this guy right here, Thomas, is shading his outside. And when that happens, let's go to the all 22, and we'll show you. When that happens, that means he's looking for help back here. Okay, this safety's going to drop down. He's going to get to the middle of the field. Peppers is the guy who has to get there. What it really comes down to is, it's a foot race. Can I beat Peppers there? And because Peppers hesitated early, Ross wins 6-6.
Colorado, a little confidence as Diego Gonzalez drives this kickoff through the end zone for the touchback. And out to the 25-yard line will come Michigan and Wilton Spain. So Michigan behind after the quick strike from Colorado, and quick is what Coach McIntyre and this Colorado offense, they want to be quick. This is a quick operating, fast-paced attack.
Yeah, it's fast-paced, and it is big play capability. But look, this is kind of a fragile group. They really don't know what they are. That's why how this game starts is really important for Colorado.
From the 25 on first down. Swing pass to Chris Evans. Speaking of playmakers, this dynamic freshman's got everybody talking, unable to get free on the sideline as he picks up three. And there's Chido Awuzie. We talked about him at the top of the broadcast. This senior corner is one of the best corners in the Pac-12 conference.
Yeah, and maybe in the country. Because he can do everything. You want to try to beat him deep, he'll be on top of you. If you want to try to force him in the run game, he'll tackle you. And if you want to try the short game, he'll close on you. He's very good.
Spate to throw again on second down. Trying to float it for Butt, and the pass incomplete. Awuzie was out there again in coverage, and it's third down.
Yeah, Awuzie's playing the outside. He has help from the inside. Keep in mind, you're to the hash to the field, so it's a shorter area to be able to defend. So they were three on two, three defenders on two there, so the odds weren't in great favor to Michigan.
Third down and 7. Blitz coming. Oh. Speed in trouble. The ball's loose. Scooped up by Colorado, and a big man running all the way in for the touchdown. It's Derek McCartney.
Let's see if his arm had started coming forward. If it started coming forward, it'll be an incomplete pass. But if not, that's 6-6.
And the grandson of Bill McCartney gives his grandpa something to smile about.
Let's see if this arm is moving forward. No, it is not moving forward. His body starts to go, but the hit is there prior to it. Here's a better look. Watch, the body starts moving forward, but the elbow is still coming back, and that's an outstanding job of Awuzie, the corner, coming off on a blitz and tying up that throwing arm. That's outstanding. Kevin. Colorado needed a fast start. They needed a boost of confidence. They got all of that and more within the first few minutes here of this first quarter.
The 16th straight game that Colorado has forced a turnover. They had 13 points off turnovers in week one. They get another seven here. Colorado has come on the road and quieted this giant crowd in Ann Arbor. A 14-0 start in just 3 minutes and 12 seconds of game action.
That was a great play by Jadobia Ouje. We're going to show you exactly how it unfolded.
First, Gonzalez will kick off. Jabril Peppers back deep. Michigan looking for a spark now of their own, down 14-0, and Gonzalez with another touchback. As we go back to the touchdown, and Matt, how did this happen?
Well, take a look. So here's your first clue for the quarterback. He's lined up directly behind. That tells you that the coverage is coming from back here. That's going to free this guy up. Now, in order to get him free, they slant their line. That's to create a shorter corner. Now, Hill coming out like that, he's got to have eyes. And he didn't have eyes. Ouje has nothing in front of him and the ability to make a big play, and he did just that.
And Derek McCartney finishing it off. Ouje, 6 career sacks, second most among all active defensive backs in FBS football. Here's Peppers on the sweep. Peppers turns it upfield. He can provide a spark quickly, and he's got a first down to the 42-yard line. 17 yards for Jabril Peppers. Afolabi Aguda with the stop there for Colorado.
They're going to go with their version of the little bit of a hurry up. Keep Colorado from doing anything personnel-wise.
And now on the wide receiver sweep to McDoom. Turn it on the Jets. And McDoom's got another first down at the Colorado 48.
And just a freshman, this guy, the crowd loves him already. As soon as he touches the ball, it's doom all over the place. But I want you to watch on the top side. The whole key was Jesu did a nice job of getting a block to allow McDoom to be able to get the corner.
At the Colorado 48 on first down. With pressure up the middle, Spate standing in, airing it deep down the sideline, batted away from Darbo by Witherspoon. And Akello Witherspoon, who does not have a tackle, but has a pass breakup now on this play.
Yeah, and what it is just a nice job of using the sideline as your friend. So you just kind of force him so the ball has to be thrown perfectly, and in this instance, it was a little bit underthrown, and he knocked the ball away, second and 10.
Spate out once more, and the give this time to the fullback. That's Khalid Hill on the handoff from John O'Korn down to the 46-yard line. A pickup of 2. And now Spate will come back in. O'Korn, the transfer from Houston, will head to the sidelines.
See, they're feeling up under the pads and checking Wilton Spate to see right there. That's the chest to see if his strength is still any good. That's what he's giving them. Apparently the answer was yes.
He's back in on 3rd and 8. Michigan down 14-0 here in the first. Spate, too tall, incomplete. He was looking for Grant Perry, and that one sailed to the sidelines, and Colorado gets another stop.
But they brought a blitz from the outside. It was picked up nicely, but it looked like Spate rushed himself a little bit. He needs to just settle down and get the ball out.
0-for-3 now on 3rd down, Michigan in this first quarter. And McIntyre had a good punt return on his first opportunity of 32 yards, waiting at the 10. McIntyre will call for the fair catch this time, and he makes it near the 12-yard line. Now we saw them working on Wilton Spate. Did it come from this hit that led to the touchdown? That arm in the air, it led to a score and a 14-0 Colorado lead. .24 to go in the first, 14-0 Colorado over Michigan. Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington from Michigan Stadium. On first down at the 12, Sefo Lufau, the swing pass to Lindsey. Phillip Lindsey on the edge, bangs down at the 15-yard line. Jabril Peppers with the tackle. Peppers has had the big hit on defense award that Michigan gives out in the locker room each of the last 2 weeks. He is, for his size, a guy who really can bring it.
Yeah, he's about 6 foot. He's about maybe 210, but he's got all the athleticism you need and a great sense of how to play this game.
Lufau on second down. That'll be a first down across the 25 to the 28-yard line as we check in for the first time in our BTN studios with Mike Hall.
Yeah, it's an early deficit for Nebraska in their non-conference game right now as well. This is Oregon's Tony Brooks James with a 20-yard score. And, of course, because they're Oregon, they went for two. They got it. Nebraska down 8-0. That's a Ducks
touchdown. So the Huskers down early at home. Michigan down early at home. Iowa lost earlier today to North Dakota State. Of course, Georgia State and Wisconsin were involved in a tussle earlier today.
Yeah, Wisconsin came back and won that game.
Second and nine at the 29 for Lufau and the Buffaloes. And the swing pass to Fields, and Fields fights his way to the 33 as we go downstairs to Lisa Byington.
Kevin and Matt listening in over on the Colorado sideline to this offense. A couple of things. Number one, Colorado's using a silent count today for the first time this year. Number two, the offensive line on that first touchdown that they scored, they were happy with the fact they didn't feel like they showed their alignment right away. They felt like Michigan didn't know what they were doing. They reacted slow. The message, Michigan is not used to playing far from behind. Let's keep pushing it, guys.
Well, down 14-0 here in the first and a third and five. Lufau on the roll, throws it short, and it's incomplete. Devin Ross trying to back up as he pulled it in, couldn't do both, and Colorado will punt.
Yeah, Lufau was playing well up until that throw, and that's fine, but Ross had to turn his back or else that's a first down. Here's the bigger piece of the puzzle. So what they found, and you heard from Lisa, this offensive line, they've gained confidence. They know they can handle this defensive front, which is a good defensive front. Keep in mind, they have not had great success with wins and losses in Colorado recently. And so for them to be competing on the big stage at the big house, that's a huge step.
Alex Kinney to punt to Jabril Peppers. Pressure coming and it's blocked! Another block for Michigan! The ball bounding free! Still loose, scooped up and taken in for the touchdown!
McCray finally got it. Big job there on the block. There were two on top of it. Looked like it could have been Peppers. I couldn't quite see. But you said it was bounding, which, you know, you don't really see a lot of balls bounding around on a football field. But McCray found it. Watch Perry.
Last week, two blocked field goals, two deflected punts, and Grant Perry scoops this one up as it bounces around and takes it in for the touchdown. The extra point is good, and Michigan jumps right back in with a special team spark.
This is great. This is outstanding. First of all, you got to get there, okay? So
Delano Hill is the guy who got there.
Delano Hill is the guy who got there. Perry ends up getting it into the end zone. So now, as you see, well, he took some time. He took his time, but that could have been.
Well, we mentioned it last week. There were two punts deflected against Central Florida. One there, and the second right here. Pennell doing the duties on that one. Michael Joes may have been the guy who got a piece of this one along with Delano Hill. Both were back there. Let's see who gets the official credit here, if we can tell on this. That's going right off the head of Joes.
Looks like it's Joes.
We know who got the touchdown. Grant Perry. And now Colorado back to work, looking for a little running room on the kickoff, and a flag is down. Tony Joel Meese was the return man. We'll wait and see about the flag. A lot of action early on here in Ann Arbor.
long conversation, making sure they've got everything right.
There are two fouls on the play. Offside. Kicking team number 34. On the return, illegal block in the back. Return team number 81. Penalties offset. Re-kick.
So another kick coming with Michigan on the board. Tonight, one of the biggest games this season in college football is on Fox. For the first time in 33 years, third-ranked Ohio State takes on Oklahoma. Don't miss this historic event tonight, 7 Eastern, only on Fox.
Speaking of other games, Cincinnati. They're for real.
Yeah, they appear to be, don't they? Saw some surprising scores today in the Big Ten Conference. This is an early surprising score, but a long way to go for Jim Harbaugh and Michigan in this one. And a big lift from the special teams unit for Michigan. Got the stop they wanted out of the defense, then the blocked punt, and the touchdown on the block. And now the re-kick.
Hey, I said I meant Louisville. Louisville just crushed Florida State.
Yes, they did.
I mean, they had no answer. That's amazing.
I thought you were impressed with Tommy Tuberville's squad in Cincinnati.
Actually, they played pretty good football, too.
Joel Meese awaits the kickoff. From the four. Cuts back at the 25. Steps through a tackle at the 30. Joel Meese finally buried at the 32-yard line. So the exchange of offsetting penalties benefits Colorado here as they'll start at their 32 after the 30-yard return.
So if you're Jim Harbaugh or Mike McIntyre, what you want to see right now is how each team reacts to what just happened. So who's going to come back and square their jaw and make it, and you know, get right back into it right away? Some guys get affected and some don't.
Donovan Lee on first down. Spins out of one tackle down to the 36. Then Gideon on the stop. Darren Shiverini, the offensive coordinator. Former Colorado Buffalo. He was a commit in 94 when the Hail Mary game happened here. Was not a part of much success in the following games against Michigan on the field. Overall, the fifth time these two teams have met, Michigan leads the series 3-1. Lufau, good protection. Nobody open. Lufau trying to scramble. He stumbles forward and gets down to the 39-yard line. A pickup of three. Gideon there to make the stop.
Kevin, you said it, and I think it's probably the most significant thing. Lufau has been getting pretty good protection here. Now, Michigan has some guys who are banged up, but look at this right here. Look at the time that he has. He's able to decipher. Now, the coverage was good. Lufau decided to take off, but that's a positive sign for this Buffalo team.
Third down and four. Michigan looking for its second straight defensive stop. Flag is down. Lufau to the air finds Ross, and Ross stopped right at the sticks at the 43-yard line, but it looked like Mike McCray may have been a little bit early there.
They're going to get the defense for offsides or in the neutral zone. He knows it.
Offside. Defense. Number five. Five-yard penalty. Results in a first down.
He said five, but he meant nine. He said five because he's doing everything else on this field today, so why not?
You saw Mike McCray looking over at Jim Harbaugh and the coaching staff, point to his chest saying, that's on me. McCray's done a lot of good things in the early stages this year, though, for Michigan on defense. A couple of sacks, a couple of forced fumbles. Second in the Big Ten coming into play today with five tackles for loss.
They're spreading out this Michigan defense. They're making them play and defend the whole field.
Four-man rush. Lufau in trouble. Rolls, throws, caught by Donovan Lee, but immediately buried along the sideline. As he made the catch, Jeremy Clark was right there to drive him to the turf.
So what that does when you have everybody spread out all the way across the field, it defines inside for you your pass protections. If you're going to try to blitz it, you have to show it.
when you're talking about disguising things, if you're going to blitz, you have to show it. What do you tell us what you mean by that?
Well, if you're all spread out and you're going to bring an extra guy, you're going to have to bring him down the box, and that'll declare it right away for you offensively.
The give to Lindsey. Lindsey breaks a tackle. And into Michigan territory, Philip Lindsey knocked out by Demonte Thomas, a first down. 10-yard pickup for the 5'8 junior from Aurora, Colorado.
This is just a nicely, well-blocked play. And this is just another confidence booster. I couldn't see if it was 8 or 9. Either McCray or Stribling had a chance to make that tackle and stumble.
Lindsey again. Down to the 40-yard line. Demonte Thomas first to get to him after the 3-yard gain. Colorado's got to be feeling awfully good, even with that block punt for a touchdown, about where they are right now.
It was important. It's important for them to have this kind of a drive coming off of a blocked kick.
Ufau 5 of 6 for 60 yards as he lines up on 2nd and 7 at the 40. Ufau out of the air, throws a dart to Shea Fields, and Fields spinning to the 22-yard line. 18-yard gain over the middle to Shea Fields. Demonte Thomas on the stop.
So there's a void in between the linebackers and the secondary, and that's what they're attacking. Yeah, this is just a really nice job. Fields can go, too. Shea Fields, it's not like he can't run. That guy can fly, too.
From the 22, Ufau under some pressure, throws it for the end zone, and it's a little too tall for Shea Fields. Pressure coming from Mike McCray, and Ufau had to get rid of it a little earlier than he wanted.
That's Don Brown, defensive coordinator, new here at Michigan. Came from Boston College, and Donnie, if you've known Donnie, I've known him for a long time. He likes to bring pressure, and he brought it that time.
There's Don Brown. Second down and 10. Pressure coming. Ufau gets rid of it in time. Ento inside the 10, still going to the 5. Kavion Ento sets up Colorado with a first and goal.
Offensive front is an outstanding protection. They have an extra guy coming. It wasn't picked up, but Ufau did a nice job of locating the receiver, and they're knocking on the door.
The all-time passing leader and total offense leader at Colorado, Sefo Ufau, has the Buffs first and goal at the 6. Ufau on the keep, and he's not going to get very far. Demonte Thomas in there on the stop. Don Brown's defense, 21 straight games without allowing multiple passing touchdowns. That is in jeopardy here today. Already one on the board for Ufau.
It might be in jeopardy right now, this down.
Second goal. Ufau, the fade for the corner to Ross, who makes the catch. It is a touchdown. With 6 for Devin Ross.
That was huge. Now keep in mind, college football, all he has to have is possession and 1 foot. And there it is. Yeah, that's 6. That is outstanding. Just a great job. Yeah, that's a great job by Ross, but an even better one by this offensive unit. They just got kicked in the teeth with 6 points, and they answered it right away.
First time this year that Michigan has allowed a red zone score. The extra point is good. And Colorado has put 21 points on the board. Michigan allowed 17 all year until today. On scoring drive for the Colorado Buffaloes, they're up 21-7. A 10-play, 67-yard drive that took 4 minutes and 38 seconds off the clock.
Evan Ross is having an impressive game. Early here in the first quarter, but they're going to have to. Michigan's going to have to adjust to this passing game.
J.U. Chesson, the deep man for Michigan, He'll watch this one go through the end zone. Back to our BTN studios in Chicago for the host of Sports Light with Mike Hall, the aptly named Mike Hall.
Well done there, buddy. We got an answer from Nebraska. The Cornhuskers are on the board as Tommy Armstrong finds Jordan Westerkamp for a 22-yard score. It's now a one-point Oregon lead, 8-7.
So an 8-7 game in Lincoln and a 21-7 game here. Both scores may seem a little bit odd, the 8-7 there, and this one with Colorado up 2 touchdowns. On first down, Smith, and Davion Smith spinning free. Down to the 35-yard line, should be a first down, a 10-yard pickup. Tedrick Thompson on the stop. Already 21 points allowed. The first two games, 17 points scored combined by Hawaii and Central Florida.
A couple things have gone on. Wilt Spate took that shot, and the ball came off high when he came back in. And they have not been able to really run the ball efficiently so far this season. This is important. They have to establish this run game.
Davion Smith trying to work up the middle. Gets a couple to the 37-yard line. Samson Kaufavalu is there. Along with Kaufavalu, you've got Josh Tupou in the middle of that defensive line, and that's a big guy that I know stood out for you as we were watching Colorado film the last couple days.
That's a big man. That's a big man. He's about 325. He's a little more than that. You know, got a couple biscuits stuffed in that shirt. But I'll tell you what, that kid doesn't move. And that's a Jim Jeffcoat stance, who's his defensive line coach.
On second and eight, here's Chris Evans, finds very little running room on the right side as Colorado swarms Olabode there first. Kenneth Olabode, the senior out of San Jose, California, one of the captains of this Colorado team.
So it's important. So it's a 34 scheme. So what does that mean? You have 3 down linemen, 4 linebackers. Tupou in the middle. Now this gone to third down, and you're going to have to get your pass rushers on the field. But they match up very well against this Michigan offensive line.
Darbo to the top of your screen. Now he'll come in motion. Third down. Spate under some late pressure finds his tight end, Jake Butt. Butt's going to have the first down, steps through a tackle, and Butt's out of bounds. Just stepped on the sideline at midfield, but it's enough for the first. A 13-yard pickup. Tedrick Thompson on the stop.
Yeah, this is what Jake Butt does very, very well. He's a guy who's just going to drag back underneath. And so what happens, sometimes you're running a stunt up front, you lose him. You lose him in the mix, and that's exactly what happened. First down.
19th straight game with at least one catch for Butt. First down from midfield, straight drop for Spate. And Spate almost throws that one into the arms of Awuzie, who was in front of Amara Darbo.
Yeah, I think they're going to find out pretty soon to stay away from Awuzie. Yeah, that's they may not know him, but after this first quarter, and if they studied tape, they should have known. This could have been a pick. Awuzie is one of the best out there.
He was studying the eyes of Darbo, and when he saw Darbo's eyes react, he turned around for that ball. Give up the middle to Davion Smith, and what a poke delivered by Olabode.
And Olabode is not very big. That's about 218 pounds. He's got those big guys in front of him. But what he can do is he can move. And so he beats the block, and boy, I'll tell you, what a nice stick right in the chest. Like to see that.
Chase Frankie came over to help out a little bit, but Olabode didn't need much help there. Third down and 10 from midfield for Michigan. Butts on the end of the line to the bottom of your screen. Pressure up the middle. Spate is in trouble. Gets rid of it. Incomplete. Just trying to avoid the pressure that was coming in hot and heavy again. And that pass rush led by Rick Gamboa will force the punt from Michigan.
That's Jim Leavitt. Jim Leavitt is their defensive coordinator. Jim Leavitt just dialed up a nice blitz. He brought more than they could handle. When you pick one, the other guy's coming. That's a nice defensive play call and excellent execution by his players.
Jim Harbaugh told us yesterday, he said, they do a lot of stuff I loved when we did it in San Francisco. Yeah. Now I got to figure out how to beat it. McIntyre will watch this punt bounce at the 5 and get into the end zone for the touchback. 56 seconds to go in the first and a 21-7 lead. And this is how it started. The deep ball to Devin Ross for the touchdown. The sack from Ouija, scooped up by McCartney, who takes it in for the touchdown, a 14-0 lead. Then a stop and a blocked punt, scoop and score eventually by Grant Perry, I promise. There he is, scoops up and scores, and then the answer right back for Colorado, the second touchdown pass of the day to Devin Ross, and the Buffs defense gets another stop, and the offense back out on the field.
All within 15 minutes.
On first down at the 20. Lufau off play action. Caught. Broken tackle. And looking for running room is Bryce Bobo at the 40. And Bobo chased out of bounds by Channing, dribbling all the way down inside the Michigan 30-yard line.
Colorado is saying, look, if you're going to leave this inside open, I'm going to take it. And that was excellent job by Lufau to wait for him to clear Peppers, and then he made the throw.
On first down, Philip Lindsay to the 28-yard line, gets two, and Colorado on the move again. A career-long 50-yard grab by Bryce Bobo has him in position once more.
Yeah, so he was waiting. Lufau was waiting for Peppers. Peppers sat, and they ran right through it. That's what you're supposed to do. Run through zone, sit down, man.
Second down and 8. Lindsay with some running room to the edge. Lindsay with a first down out of bounds at the 17-yard line. A good block on the outside from Bryce Bobo, the wide receiver, to spring Lindsay.
I think this Colorado team is gaining confidence as we go. At the end of this quarter, they have been the dominant team.
That's the end of the first quarter.
We have played one quarter here in Ann Arbor, Michigan, with a little celebration after the block punt. But more often than not, it's been the Buffs who've been doing the celebrating. Up 21-7 and looking for more. Plays of 10 yards or more against this Michigan D.
That's explosive. I mean, that's an outstanding job. And what that really does, especially after that block punt, that lets you know they believe in what they're doing right now. I love a competent team.
Ross with a pair of touchdowns already in motion. On second and 4, Lufau on the roll. Pressure comes and he's sacked. Ben Gideon, as he looked up, was right in his face and he dropped him.
So for the second play in a row, they have Gideon in the inside and he's tracking that quarterback. He breaks it, you go get him. That's exactly what Gideon did very well. Gideon runs very well.
Third down and 10 at the Michigan 17. Ross again, the motion man. They set up the screen for Ross. Ross in trouble and he's dropped. Jabril Peppers shed the block and made the tackle almost in the same motion, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, so you want to know how some guys are just better than everybody else. Here's a simple illustration as to why. Jabril Peppers takes on the block. They're trying to get after him. He just sheds it like you're supposed to, but it's not easy to do, and then makes the tackle. That's just outstanding work.
A 36-yard field goal try for Diego Gonzalez here to try to add to the lead. And the field goal by Gonzalez is no good. Michigan gets the stop, and Colorado comes up empty on a very promising drive. And will that provide a spark for the Michigan offense? This missed field goal, the defense turns away the Buffaloes. No question that was off the mark as Gonzalez comes up empty. So now first down for Michigan at their own 20-yard line. What do you want to see from this offense here, Matt?
A consistency. That's all you want to see. And I want to see Wilton Spaeht gain a little bit more, not confidence, but I want to see him kind of get over that little shot that he took. They need to still establish a run game. They haven't been able to do that.
Play action. Spaeht with good protection. wings it to the sideline for Khalid Hill, and Hill close to the first down at the 29.
That's nicely done by Spade. He was trying to get deep. It was taken away, and he came back to his secondary receiver. You still end up second and short and put yourself in a good position to get to the first down. You don't have to win the game with one play. All you have to do is be consistent and move the chains.
On second down and one, Smith met in the hole, but he fights forward for the first down. Olabode came up and took on Davion Smith, and Smith outweighs Olabode, able to fight forward and get the first.
Olabode's very active. Not, like I said, he's not very big. He's like 218 or so, but he has very good movement. And I'll tell you, one of the things that you can see on film is he believes what he sees in front of him. By that, I mean he believes his eyes. Some guys, younger players, they don't. So something will happen, your keys will happen, and you won't believe him. He does.
Ty Isaac now in at running back on first down for Michigan. From the 31. Spate to the air. One-on-one coverage on the sideline, incomplete. Darbo, the intended receiver. Witherspoon on the coverage for Colorado.
Witherspoon and Rouge have been outstanding here today. The only place that ball was going to have to go was to the outside. Witherspoon's on the inside the whole time. You'd like to push him more to the sideline, but that ball has to be thrown to the outside. Anything less than that is an incompletion. You have second and 10.
Well, Mike McIntyre told us when we chatted with him the other day, he said, look, guys, I've got pro corners.
Yeah.
You may not have seen him yet, but trust me, you will.
Oh, Luge, nicely done.
And Ty Isaac, nowhere to go as Chido Awuzie jumping in.
So here's what happens. It happens the same thing with Peppers. You have a guy you know has good football skills. You can see him down below, right down here. See that? So he's lined up in the slot. He has a feel for blitzing. When you have those guys, you let them make the plays. They do it with Peppers. They do it with Awuzie.
He led this team in tackles for loss a year ago. First time that's happened from a defensive back since they first started tracking the stat in 1969. Third and nine. Spade chased, airing it deep, and he'll overshoot Amaro Darbo. And Michigan will punt it away. Witherspoon out there on the coverage.
And a slight boo, a little ooh from the crowd. Like, but I got to tell you, for Wilton Spate, that's okay. Instead of trying to force a ball in, just let the ball, throw it away, and live for another down. Let your defense take over and kind of do their thing. That's not bad.
Tough day overall so far for Spate, though, Matt. 3 for 12 for 25 yards.
Well, he hasn't had corners like this. Not only one, two good corners.
And the punt out of bounds from Kenny Allen. And Colorado going to start across their own 30-yard line. Buffaloes with a 21-7 lead in the ball. Looking for a little confidence on the road. Oh, yeah. Coming live on BTN to go. East Lansing, not a bad spot to be for that BTN tailgate next week on first down. Little end around. Devin Ross in some trouble. That did not fool Jabril Peppers at all. A loss of two.
He had it right from the start. Lined up outside in the slot, and as soon as the motion went away, your eyes as a defender go to the other side. He saw it coming and took care of it. Sets up second and long. Well played by Peppers.
Sixth tackle already for Jabril Peppers today. There will be more. Second and 12 at the 31. Lufau 10 of 12 for 149 yards and two touchdowns in this first half. Play action. Caught by Ross. That's a first down. Hill on the coverage, but Delano Hill tried to rip it out of the hands of Ross. Couldn't get it free. A 14-yard pickup and move the chains.
Kevin, at the start of this game, we said Lufau had to play his best game. Well, he's off to that start. He is taking charge and in control of this offense right now. The ball is exactly where it's supposed to be. He's impressive.
And that fast start has taken this giant crowd out of the game for the moment. From the 45 on first down, Lindsay the carry gets 3 to the 48-yard line.
Lufau's seeing the field very well, and Ross has been He's been money here today. He has been getting open. They have not had an answer for him.
Second and seven. Swing pass Lindsey in some trouble. He's dropped. Wonderful open field tackle by Delano Hill. And here comes a flag at the end of the play.
Delano Hill had to make that play because they picked the coverage. And Hill had to come off it. Instead of staying with his guy, he made a nice read and came off and made the play.
The flag came in after the play was over. Not sure if somebody was taunting. Some sort of unsportsmanlike conduct.
There's no foul on the play. It'll be third down.
Now Mike McIntyre says, well, why'd you throw the flag? Maybe they thought Hurst was late.
Yeah, that's a good non-call. Big down here. Has to have good protection.
Third and 10. And now that crowd back into it here in Ann Arbor. Incomplete for McIntyre. Delano Hill on the coverage, and Michigan's defense gets the stop.
Rufo would like to have that one back because he did have protection. He just let that ball sail on him. Nicely done by Michigan. Good defense all the way around. They still have not had a consistent pass rush.
Alex Kinney to punt it away.
That's on the kicker. That was just poorly kicked. It needs to elevate off his foot. Instead, it went straight in. Probably his hair got in his eyes.
Special teams, a big part of Michigan's win last week. Look at this one.
Yeah, watch the trajectory. That's low as could be. His own guy blocking. That just came off his foot poorly.
Shane Callahan had no idea he was going to get a block punt today. And now at the Colorado 38, huge break for Michigan. Can they cash in here? Spate to the air, but with room to run. He's got great speed for a tight end, and he's out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Tedrick Thompson on the stop, but a pickup of 21 for Jake Butt.
All they're doing is clearing out the right side and swinging Butt underneath. And you tend to see with guys crossing through zones, you tend to lose them. And if you're dropping to that side, you don't see him, so there's an open
sideline
area.
Sideline warning, Colorado bench. It's their first warning.
Papa Butt very happy with what he saw there. His son had two drops last week, and we were talking with Wilton Spate yesterday. He said he caught about 600 passes a day off the jugs machine, trying to make up for that one. On the sweep, Chesson. With a blocker in front, Chesson turns the corner, touchdown!
That's on Khalid Hill. That's really well done by Khalid Hill. He did a nice job of making, he gets that block right there to the next level. Watch his feet. Yeah, that's a nice tightrope, he's clean.
J.U. Chesson finds the end zone again for Michigan. Few in the country have scored more since the end of last October than that man, J.U. Chesson. And Chesson on the ground, able to take this one in. Michigan takes advantage of the special teams miscue. They're right back at PA Goodworks team. The team honors football student athletes for exemplary community service. J.U. Chesson, nominee for that squad. Gets into the end zone for the touchdown. And coming out of the end zone. And nowhere to go is Jolmice. Jolmice stopped shy of the 20-yard line. And Colorado up a touchdown with the football. Alongside Matt Millen, I'm Kevin Kugler. This has been a wild start to this one in Ann Arbor. What do you expect to see now from Colorado's offense and Michigan's defense?
Well, I think they have to do exactly what happened the last time they had a block kick. They have to be able to gather themselves and then be consistent moving the football, just like Michigan just did. Now, the one thing that Michigan did that I really like is get Chesson involved. He has big play capability and big speed, and they were able to take advantage of it on that reverse.
On first down at the 18-yard line. And nowhere to go up the middle. Michigan's defense stiffening. Rashawn Gary, the true freshman, in to make the stop. Going to be utilized by Michigan. Wolverines will take the timeout with 8:05 remaining in the second. Down by
Michigan.
7.
Michigan, they're first.
Just rotating in perpetual motion, apparently. 21-14. Michigan down by 7.
That's because it can't roll.
Second and 10 at the 18-yard line. Lufau under pressure. Hit as he got rid of it by Wormley.
Calling it an
third down.
Yeah, they're calling it an incomplete pass, so his arm was coming forward. If not, that would be where the ball goes out of bounds. Let's see exactly where it was. The arm starts. Whoa, that they're going to rule it an incomplete pass, and so they'll stay with that call on the field. His arm does start coming forward.
But a little extra energy on the side of the Wolverines right now. Colorado 0-for-3 on third down with Fields in motion.
Middle of the field is open.
And a timeout taken by Colorado.
Charge timeout, Colorado. They're first.
21-14.
This will be a
Colorado
1 minute timeout.
With Colorado by a touchdown facing a third and 10 at their own 18-yard line. And another long third down conversion attempt here for Colorado. Their first two third downs were of 4 and 5 yards, but Michigan stiffening, and now the last two have been 10 yards. Lufau hit again as he throws, and the pass is incomplete. Rashawn Gary providing the spark for Michigan.
Yeah, just a freshman, and a lot of huge expectations placed on Rashawn Gary. You can see him number 3 on the top side here. He has an ability to be able to get to the edge, and they have not been able to do that, but Rashawn Gary's giving him he's got some juice to him.
Jeremy Irwin is having some problems with him. Speaking of problems, it's time to punt for Colorado. This has been a major problem. First punt blocked and returned for a touchdown. The second punt, he kicked it into his offensive line, neither of which were the desired result. And now a flag is down as the play clock hits 0.
Delay a game, kicking team. 5-yard penalty, remains fourth down.
So this is, if you're Colorado, you can't let the wheels fall off right here. You can't have another mistake. You haven't had success in the kicking game. Just get the ball off, block your guys up front, and let your defense get back on the field.
And oh, by the way, as you do all that and you get rid of the ball, then you got to deal with Jabril Peppers, who's waiting to return it.
Did I forget that?
Kinney. Much better punt this time. Peppers at the 44-yard line. Got a block and has a lane. Jabril Peppers upended across the 40, but Michigan going to have the short field to work with inside the 40-yard line. Tony Jomice on the stop of Jabril Peppers. Enjoy the lighter side of Big Ten sports on BTN's new late-night show, Sports Life, with Mike Hall. Each week, join Mike along with correspondents in New York and Los Angeles as they hang out with your favorite Big Ten athletes, coaches, alums, and fans. Don't miss Sports Life with Mike Hall Wednesday night, only on BTN.
It's a big series right here for the Michigan offense. They need to get 6 points, but for this Colorado defense right now, you have to hold them to at least a field goal try. So they can't give up a first down here. That would be a win.
Spade on first down over the middle to Butt, and Butt drilled down immediately at the 35 of Olabode. And it'll be second down for Michigan. Kenneth Olabode, good strong tackler. We've seen that several times today. Came in with 10 tackles and a sack. Devion Smith now in the backfield on second and eight. Spate steps up, throws for Butt again, and Butt with a first down. Ryan Moeller on the stop, but not before Michigan moves the chains. 12-yard pickup.
Yeah, this whole thing is based off the protection. He's got a lot of time to be able to see that thing, and Butt does a nice job of coming back to the ball away from Moeller, and it's able to pick up that first down.
From the 23, Devion Smith the carry. And Smith picks up two. Olabode there again on the stop.
He's having a really active day, Olabode. He's just a good athletic kid. You know, we've talked about him before. He's very active inside in the run game and also in the pass game. He's taken away some things.
And I don't know if you can feel it through your TV set, but you could definitely hear at Michigan Stadium, feel the energy and the momentum shift that has happened for Michigan.
Exactly.
Second and eight at the 21. Blitz coming. Spade in trouble. Steps away. Spade staying alive. And now Spade's going to get some positive yardage. Excellent play by Spade.
That's a huge play by Spade. They had a free blitzer off the edge, and he couldn't get there. Yeah, it was Thompson, number nine. Watch how he just shakes him. You have to, at that point, the most important thing isn't the hit. It's just to get the guy down. Spate, though, does a nice job of stepping up, avoiding it, and creates third down.
Huge third down for Colorado's defense right here. As you mentioned, Matt, you had to try and hold them with a short field to a field goal try. And with that big third down, Jim Harbaugh wants a little more time to talk
charge
this one over.
Out. Michigan, they're second.
So Michigan will take the timeout and third side of the ball here.
Well, if you're Jim Leavitt, I think you roll the dice right here, the defensive coordinator for the Colorado Buffaloes. And I think you go with a little man with pressure. And you want to force Spate to make a quick throw, and you jump your coverage. It's a short field. And really, the only way to beat that is mostly on crossing routes unless you go to the corner. So I look for a blitz here.
Jake Butts lined up on the bottom of your screen on the left side of the line. He has three third down catches this year. All have been touchdowns. Airing this one for Chesson in the end zone, and Chesson out of bounds. He made the catch, but he couldn't get the foot down. Witherspoon on the coverage, and they just missed six by inches.
Yeah, but that's a great job by Witherspoon. And also, I got to tell you, the officiating was outstanding right there. Really well done by Witherspoon. So he's out of bounds. Is completely out of bounds. Witherspoon used the sideline as his help, and that's what he did. Now watch, the official on the one side looks to the other, and they look for the catch, control, and where was his feet. Really well done.
37-yard try for Kenny Allen. That would match his long of the year in this short season, and this one is wide to the right, no good.
Huge win for Colorado right there. They did, that defense did what exactly what it had to do. Now they had some help from the kicker, but they forced the kick, and it was no good.
First miss for Allen. And now 21-14 holds with Colorado taking over. That kick was straight right the entire way. And Jim Harbaugh,
Now you can say what you want about Jim Harbaugh, but I'm going to tell you what I love about him. And I loved it as a player. He is ultra competitive. and he has that competitive drive, and he's instilling it in his players. And that's what you're seeing here. And they're fighting back, and they're keep on competing. I just think he's good for college football. I think he's good for football, period. I love his competitiveness.
He's great for Michigan. Not too many Michigan fans would disagree with that one. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Lufau, the slant caught by Fields. And Fields down after a 7-yard pickup in the arms of Ben Gideon. Coming up tonight on BTN, Duke and Northwestern battle under the lights in Evanston. Coverage continues right after our game on BTN and BTN to go. Second and 3 at the 27, and a big hole and a first down for Philip Lindsay across the 40 to the 42-yard line. He gets 15 before Peppers can catch up.
Nice things done inside by 56, Tim Lenott. The center, Alex Kelly, does a nice job. And number 74 right there, that's Alex Kelly. That's just well blocked up front.
Good protection again. Nobody open. And Lufau throws it back to the sideline where Shea Fields came back for it and picks up 9. Jabril Peppers on the coverage and a flag down on that same sideline. Yeah,
but I wanted to want you to see his foot was out of bounds, and that official's going to throw his hat. You see him right there? Right here at the top of your screen right there. That's what he's doing. So he's going to start taking his foot. So he has to establish himself back in bounds, which is
illegal
to say only get your foot back in.
The receiver went out of bounds on his own, came back in, was the first to touch. Penalty results in a loss of down, second down.
Well officiated, right on top of it. Good job. Anytime you see officials running around with no hats on, it means one of two things.
It's windy.
Or the guy ran out of bounds.
The previous play is under further review.
Well, they're going to look at this, and they're going to see just what you saw, Matt.
Well, they're going to see if he was forced. That's what they want to see. If he's forced and tries to come back in, it's different. Yeah, here's Shea Fields. He's right down here. And so what you want to see, that's Jabril Peppers. No, it's going to be the right call the whole way. He's not even close to him.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Second down.
Yeah, excellent work all the way around by this crew. Got it right. And Colorado and Fields lose a 9-yard completion, and they lose the down, so it's second and 10 at the 42.
Okay, so lost in all that, Kevin. Your call on first down was 100% correct. You said lots of time. Good protection, and that's been the bugaboo a little bit here for this Michigan defense. They haven't been able to get pressure with 4.
Bringing a little more this time as Peppers comes on the blitz, and that one off the hands of Ross, incomplete. Boy, Jabril Peppers like a heat-seeking missile. Aiming for number 13, Sefo Lufau.
Yeah, Lufau knows exactly where he has to go. He sees it coming right down the middle. That ball just had to be up a little bit, and it would have been a big play. Instead, you're third down. Let's see what you got.
Third down and 10. 21-14 Colorado here in the second. 4-man rush. Lufau dumps it short and incomplete. Shea Fields, if he's able to catch, is going to have some room on the angle he was running on. Yeah. But instead, it's fourth down.
Yeah, he might still be running. And Lufau knew it. And he started to. It was ready, fire, aim. Not going to be happy with that one. But if you're a Michigan fan, that guy right there, Jabril Peppers, you got to love this guy. He reminds me of a bigger Tyrann Mathieu. He's just got a great sense of playing this game. Great football intelligence.
There's Alex Kinney. Clean punt this time. Peppers from the 25. Jabril Peppers a little spin. And Peppers electric every time he touches the ball. Even on a play that doesn't look like it's getting much, he picks up 12 on the return. And there have been some miscues in the special teams for sure. The block punt that eventually turns into a touchdown for Grant Perry and Michigan. The missed field goal from Diego Gonzalez, his first miss. A punt into the back of your offensive lineman, which is never how you want it to happen. All of those things hurting Colorado, and yet here they are on the road against the fourth-ranked team in the nation and still leading, despite all that, with 4:28 to go in the second quarter. Michigan with a first down at the 37. The give to Chesson. Chesson to the edge. And Chesson fights forward to the 43. A six-yard pickup on the play.
I agree with trying to get the ball in Chesson's hands. He has big play capability with that speed. You want to get him out in space. They haven't been able to do it in the passing game because these corners have been covering really well. Awuje and Witherspoon have had a great game. So if you're a play caller, find another way.
Chesson in motion again. Second and four. Straight drop for Spate. Sets it up for Butt. Butt with a first down into Colorado territory. The ball pops out as a flag flies in. And Butt and Michigan will have it at the 45. That flag came in very late at the end of the play as the tackle was being made by Isaiah Oliver.
You've been seeing Jake Butt on these underneath crossing routes all game long.
Sideline interference, unsportsmanlike conduct. Colorado bench, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
That's their second one, and the second one turns into an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty.
And they warned him once. You can see him back underneath. He's just crossing through. Yeah, and so you're looking up in the top, right up in here. That's where they're looking.
Watch the official.
So he runs into him, and that's why they're going to throw that flag. See that white area in there? You have to stay out of that. Jim Leavitt, got the defensive coordinator, gets so excited, he just can't help himself.
On first down at the 30, nice little cross by Smith, and Smith able to get down to the 26-yard line, close to the 25, nearly a 5-yard pickup for Davion Smith. Isaiah Oliver on the tackle. There's Jim Leavitt.
Good D coordinator. Yeah, he's been making some gutsy calls here, and he's going to have to dig a little deeper in his pocket right now because he's going to need some right down here on this, about to get into the red zone.
Spate on second down. Finds Khalid Hill, and Hill powering forward for the first to the 19. Rick Gamboa. Got steamrolled a bit by Khalid Hill.
Yeah, I had a chance to run into Khalid yesterday in the building there, and he put together pretty good. Got himself a nice, thick football body, and he used it right there.
6'2", 263 pounds. The senior out of Detroit. From the 19, Michigan back in the red zone. Ty Isaac as he collides with Spate. And he'll lose a yard back to the 20.
That was a good hit by Spate. Stopped him right in the hole.
Unintentionally from Wilton Spate.
Yeah, sometimes you get your feet crossed, and that's exactly what they did.
Here, Ty, you take it. Second and 11. Davion Smith now back in at running back.
Well, Ty always goes to the runner, you know that.
Spade off play action with all day to throw for the end zone. Almost intercepted on the dive by Tedrick Thompson.
Thompson's playing the middle of the field. Awuje's on that coverage. That was really, this is outstanding coverage. They've had nowhere to go with this ball. Thompson, like I said, he's playing the middle of the field, and he's just eyeballing that ball. Awuje was all over the coverage inside to Darbo. Big down right here.
Entering the game, Michigan was 15 of 25 on the year on third down. Today, they're 1 for 7.
Nobody moving. They're not going to play. They're going to zone it.
On third down, pressure coming. Spate for the end zone for Darbo. Incomplete.
They like the one-on-one matchups outside, but Colorado has been winning them all game long. They have not been able to separate with their speed. This is good corner play here today.
And they brought Awuje on that blitz again, yeah. Matt, and gave it up for Witherspoon, who has been terrific all day long.
Yeah, that was a zone blitz.
So now on to try the field goal. Kenny Allen, he missed from 37 earlier. This from 39. And Allen this time right down the middle. And Michigan within four, 21-17. 1:59 remaining in an entertaining first half here on BTN. Good friends, but good friends are one thing. Adversaries on Saturday, that's another thing. They can be friends after the game.
See Jim Leavitt there on the sideline. He's worked up a pretty good lather here in that first half.
What a good ball game so far.
Yes,
21-17, Colorado by four. Buffs will get it back. And they'll get it back at the 25-yard line as we check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
This is the first time that the two gyms are actually facing each other, and a ton of mutual respect between them. When I asked Leavitt to describe what it was like to work for Harbaugh in San Francisco, he immediately said a blast. He said, I like being around guys who have a passion for life and the game, frankly. And when I asked him, you know, what would it be like to go against him as a competitor, he didn't want to make it about gym versus gym. He said it's kind of all about the players. But, Matt, you talked about how they're both competitors. What do you think? Competitor on one side? Better on the other side.
Yeah,
come
absolutely.
On.
Absolutely. And so I think right now is like who sweats the most, and I think Leavitt's winning that battle.
I'm not sure Leavitt has stopped moving. Plus, Leavitt's gotten a 15-yard penalty called on him today.
And he's got full sun, so that's a little unfair.
From the 25, Lufau with a flag down over the middle. It's caught by Fields across the 40, and Fields down at the 46-yard line. But this one looks like it's coming back. Big gain on the play of 21.
Holding offense number 74. 10-yard penalty, replay first down.
That's Alex Kelly
in
the center.
You see him right in the middle with the ball in his hand. Yeah, so that's on Maurice Hurst. And so he just gave him a little pirouette. It wasn't like it was a big hole.
Now, say you were Maurice Hurst.
Oh, he helped me all the way.
So back it up now to the 15 where it's first down and 20. Lufau on first down. That pass deflected and incomplete. He was looking for Fields. Channing stribbling right on top of Shea Fields.
Yeah,
second down.
Stribbling, and he drove on that too. He drove hard on that. A double move right there, or a stutter, would have gotten him. But Strickland believed his eyes, studied the film, knows what he has. And a nice play sets up this second and 20. See if they don't go down here. Number one down here, Shea Fields, down below. He's got a lot of field to work with back here.
Lufau going to keep it himself. Didn't have a lot of field to work with there as he takes it to the 18-yard line. Ben Gideon on the stop. Coming up at halftime, Dave, Jerry, and Howard have all the scores and highlights from today's Big Ten action, and there's a lot to talk about coming up on the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. So now third and 17. Michigan's used a couple of timeouts. They have just the one remaining. So maybe Colorado content to burn a little clock here, Matt, get into the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, they should use all that 15 seconds left.
Lufau going to keep it again. And Lufau down to the 19-yard line, and Jim Harbaugh uses that final Michigan timeout, stopping the clock with 53 seconds remaining, and Michigan's going to have the chance to try to put themselves in position to add some points to the
first
scoreboard.
Timeout, Michigan. The third
quick timeout,
timeout
for us. A 30-second timeout at the end of the first half when we return. What a difference a quarter makes for that man. 9 of 11 for 150 yards in the first quarter. 4 for 10 for 17 yards in the second quarter.
That just speaks to Donnie Browning, adjustments he made on the defense.
And Kinney on the rollout, the line drive punt to Jabril Peppers. Peppers finds a crease and just caught around the ankles. What a tackle made by Isaiah Oliver. Jabril Peppers with more room to roam, and Oliver just able to get the ankle tackle.
Kev, sometimes you watch players and they just are just like they're going at a different speed than everybody else. That's Jabril Peppers. When he took that return right there, he just hit another gear. He's fun to watch.
Oh. Not if you're Jim Levitt or anybody else.
This is big right here for both teams. You gotta, Michigan, you'd like to get six. Colorado, you want to hold them to nothing.
Spate, quick toss to Darbo with blockers. Darbo breaks a tackle. Darbo down the sideline. Darbo takes it to the house. Michigan with the lead.
Kevin, that was a combination of outstanding running by Darbo and poor tackling by Colorado.
Gamboa, Laguda, each with a chance to bring him down, and Darbo able to slip through the grasp. Kenny Allen for the extra point, and Michigan leads by three, 24-21. They were down 21-7 at one point. But the Wolverines have roared back late in this first half.
That's what you want to see from a young team and a competitive team. Don't quit. Look at Darbo just run through. There's a missed tackle. There's another missed tackle. But it's a nice job of running from Amara Darbo.
Fourth catch of the year. Or rather, ninth catch of the year, four touchdowns now for Darbo.
That's a nice stiff arm right there. Shea Fields. So remember we said after the first quarter that Colorado team outplayed Michigan. That second quarter, it was all Michigan.
24-21. And if you were somebody who was watching early, saw Colorado jump up on Michigan 21-7, then had to leave to run some errands, you've come back seeing a very different Michigan team in the second quarter.
Special teams ignited them.
And it'll be down in the end zone. So Colorado's got two timeouts left. They'll have it at the 25-yard line. Are you content at this point to just put it in your pocket, get into the locker room, and try to make some adjustments?
Yeah, well, so how they'll do it is he'll run it here first right away. And if he gets anything, then they'll kick it up to another gear. But if they don't, then they'll just be content to let it go and live for another day.
Colorado will get the football to start the second half as they won the toss and elected to defer.
Now they got that look like we're going to take a knee. And they will.
They are indeed going to be content to just get out of here down by three and head to the locker room and live to fight another day. But this crowd in Ann Arbor, a little happier right now than they were about 15 minutes ago, at least 15 minutes of game action. 24-21, Michigan has roared back to take the three-point halftime lead.
That's what the number four team in the country is supposed to do. You get down, you have a little adversity, you straighten your shorts, you get back on the horse, and you ride it right into the middle of it. That's exactly what they did.
Wilton Spate, 124 yards and a touchdown in the first half. And Michigan at halftime leads Colorado 24-21.
Time of possession. Yeah. They deserve to win this game, and hats off to them. They continue to be one of the more remarkable stories in college football. We'll update you on everything else going on, including a key showdown in Lincoln. Huskers and Ducks has been everything we hoped it would be to this point. That and much more in the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report.
There are countless.
Little havoc, and that seemed to be kind of a pivot point for Michigan's defense. And of course, Jabril Peppers has been all over the field.
Peppers is tonight. He's a combination like Woodson. When Woodson was here, he's that kind of player. And he's also got some Tyrann Mathieu in him that he can, he's versatile and has just a great sense of the game.
And the kickoff, Joel Meese from the goal line. He had stopped completely, restarts his momentum, and Joel Meese tripped up at the 20-yard line. He tried to go across the grain, and Jeremy Clark was right there to make the stop at the 20. So Lufau and company coming back out, down three to start this third quarter.
So the same thing we said at the start of this game, is going to apply right here. They need to establish yet again that they are, you know, that they're going to be here for the long haul. And so how do you do that? Do you just start being consistent? Consistent in a run game, consistent pass-wise, and you need to punctuate it with a score.
On first down, quick toss and a catch to Devin Ross, and Ross gets pounded down at the 26. Delano Hill on the stop for Michigan.
As long as they continue to stay on that top shoulder and the safety sitting deep in the middle of the field, they'll keep taking that.
Lufau will keep, and Lufau with a first down to the 31-yard line. Chris Wormley and his size 18 shoes on the stop.
Yeah, but that's not good right there. Wormley, because Lufau, they have to have Lufau. Remember, he had that Liz Frank injury. I hope it's not anything like that, but he's hurt.
He is not doing well right now.
Yeah, so if I'm defensively right now, he's going to hand this ball off. You want to crowd this line of scrimmage. You're not going to let him run around back there, that's for sure.
Lufau looking deep, airing it deep. He's got a man out there. It's Fields, and Shea Fields all the way for the touchdown.
Lufau was awesome. That was outstanding by Lufau. Shea Fields got to the middle of the field. That's one thing. But Lufau, in pain, delivered a shot. And that's 70 yards. That's tremendous football by Lufau.
Seventh career play for Shea Fields of 50 yards or more, a 70-yard bomb as Lufau paid the price getting rid of it.
He's limping along. Now watch him. That's great football.
He's grabbing his right leg as he goes down, and he gets rid of it to Shea Fields, who takes it to the house. And the hit was really not anything from Ryan Glasgow. This was more from the play before.
This isn't a big hit. This is just pure guts and making that throw. See how he's holding it there? They need Lufau. I mean, he's delivered. He has delivered today.
You mentioned the Liz Frank injury of a year ago that ended his season early. They only put one screw in. He never went home. He stayed at Colorado and he worked. But that Liz Frank is just an injury of the foot where one or more of the metatarsal bones are displaced. This is where he hurt it. Or he hurt his foot, at least, or his ankle, right there as he went down awkwardly in the arms of Wormley. And then the next play, he throws a 70-yard touchdown pass.
Wouldn't
goes
come
down.
Out.
No.
Kev, he wouldn't come out. And he was a hurting buckaroo. Now he knows he's hurt.
That's really where he knew.
Limped himself right back to the huddle, limped himself into that pass protection. Like I said, I would have definitely played it as a run. You're not going to put the ball in a hurt guy's hands to do something like that. And that's exactly what they did, and he delivered.
His backup is a freshman, Steven Montez. Montez threw a touchdown on his first career attempt last week against Idaho State, and Montez warming up. The redshirt freshman from El Paso. So Montez loosening as the Colorado athletic training staff works frantically.
What a phenomenal play by Lufau.
Diego Gonzalez. And now Jabril Peppers. And Peppers with a hole. Peppers with speed. Peppers to the edge and chased out of bounds as he gets to the sideline, right into the quarterback on the sideline. Jabril Peppers runs into Lufau, and Awuzie chased him out after the 55-yard return.
I don't know what else to say about this guy. This guy's just got it. He's got it. New Jersey kid, he brings it all.
Spade on play action. One more look on the kick return. as Lufau being tended to on the sidelines. And oh,
you see that? See this coach right here? He was funny. He was like, I'll take care. I won't let you. And then he moved.
Continuing to work on Lufau on the sideline. Second and 7 after the 3-yard scramble by Spate. Toss play, Davion Smith looking for the edge. He's got it. Smith got a block, and now down the sideline. Smith cuts back, touchdown.
That's one way to get your running game going. It looked initially like Colorado had enough bodies on the edge to be able to protect the edge. And then they just blocked them all out, and the next thing you know, old Jed's a millionaire down the left sideline.
Kenny Allen's extra point is good, and a 31-28 lead. Michigan delivers the answer thanks to the BTN standout return from Jabril Peppers that ended in the lap of Lufau as he's tended to on the sidelines. And then Davion Smith with a rushing touchdown, his first of the year. And Michigan with a BTN standout answer. They lead it by 3. Upon them, the score in this one, Michigan 31, Colorado 28, and of course the game at the end of the year. But that's a long way from now. Right now, Michigan's in a game, 31-28. Leading by 3 over Colorado. Jolmice awaiting the kickoff. And Jolmice will see that one slip through his fingers as we slip to Chicago and get an update with Mike Hall.
Kevin, Nebraska has taken the lead. Tommy Armstrong looks back and finds Brian Reimers with the catch and the stretch. Give Nebraska 21-20 lead in the third.
Couple of good ball games this afternoon in the Big Ten Conference. Lisa Byington has been keeping an eye down on the sidelines on Sefa Lufau. What have you learned as he makes his way back out on the field, Lisa?
Yeah, you can see it. He's tough. They're attending to his right ankle and doing some strength tests. He could barely put pressure on it. He was grimacing in pain. I thought there's no way he's going to go in. And as I'm thinking that, he says to the trainers, "Take me up. I'm going back in." And he's back in.
And on first down, he goes to the air with blockers in front. Devin Ross trying to find some room, but he cannot slip past Delano Hill, who got over to make the stop. And, boy, you see Lufau, part of his game, Matt, is his mobility. He doesn't have that right now.
No, he doesn't, and that will hurt the offense. But then, you know, sometimes
timeout for
other senses
player.
Take over.
Delano Hill now down.
Yeah, Delano Hill worked off the block. They had it blocked up, but he did a nice job of working off the block to make that tackle to set it up in 2nd and 7.
Delano Hill, the senior from Detroit, had the interception return for a touchdown against Hawaii in the opener. One of two in that game for the Michigan secondary. Channing Stribling with the other. Historic event tonight, 7 Eastern, only on Fox. That is going to be an exciting game filled with implications. Lufau pumps, throws, deflected and incomplete. Lufau took a shot as he got rid of that one.
That was
Wormley and Lufau with a little love afterwards.
Yeah, McCray got under that ball and forced that incompletion. You can see Wormley. That's been a great talk with Chris Wormley just yesterday. And he's a big, powerful man. You mentioned about his size 18 shoes, but he's going to power you as he did right there off of Irwin.
Third down and 7. Pressure coming late. Lufau in trouble and he's sacked. Glasgow and McCray combine on the sack and Lufau hobbles to the sideline.
That angle, that's the difference in him. Previous to that injury, he would have been moving out of the pocket already. But now he's a sitting duck, just sitting back down inside. You can see they just collapsed the pocket. Nowhere to go with the ball. Good coverage down the field. That's a big difference with no mobility for Lufau.
Alex Kinney to punt. Every punt seemingly an adventure today. This one rather benign as it takes a good Colorado bounce and will roll down inside the 30-yard line and die at the 29. So Michigan's offense heads back out onto the field. 11:58 to play in the third. 3-point game at the Big House. Pivotal moment in this game, Matt Millen. Michigan leading 31-28. Sefo Lufau injured. Michigan on the field offensively. And Lufau now headed to the locker room.
Yeah, and so it's incumbent upon this defense to make a stand here. They can't give up any more points. So they're going to have to be able to just dig in here, or it's going to unravel fast.
Michigan more than happy to try to get it to unravel for Colorado here. As Spate will go to the air on first down, throws it short to Davion Smith, and a fine tackle by Rick Gamboa, driving into him at the 31, just a 2-yard pickup on the play.
Yeah, nicely done by Gamboa, just sitting in the zone. Let him have the completion. We'll just make the tackle. Live for another down. Second and 8, you're good.
So much time left in this game. Just 11:33 still left in the third. And there is Lufau in the tunnel on the way to the locker room, trying to will that ankle back to life. And a flag down.
That's going to be Kyle Kalis.
All start. Offense, number 67. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
First offensive penalty of the year.
Wow.
Against Michigan. That's some discipline.
That is good discipline. Jim's not impressed, however.
No. This is a team that had 87 penalties as a team last year. They came in with only 5 this year into this game today, and that's the first on the offense. Second and 13. Spate under some pressure. That pass is deflected. Davion Smith able to catch it, but Gamboa right there to make the stop back at the 21. A loss of 5. And now a third down and long. 2 plays. Colorado's gotten what they wanted out of their defense so far.
Yeah, so this is big right here if you're a Colorado Buffalo fan. So you've got to be able to look. You're going to play a zone, let them throw the ball underneath and make the tackle. Your tackling has to be sound, unlike it was a little bit earlier when he went down the sideline and scored 6.
Third and 18. Spate deflected into the air. That pass bounding away, and that's incomplete.
Outstanding.
Christian Shaver got it, man.
Yeah, Shaver got his hands on it. Ball went flying. But that's an outstanding job of the defense. You wanted to get 3 and out, give your offense a chance. Now, you don't know what it's going to look like without Lufau, but you do know you got to take care of your business. Watch the presence, get the hands up in the air, well-timed, and it gives you a chance.
2 deflected passes on 3 plays in that series, and now Michigan will punt with Jay McIntyre back. And that's going to bounce at the 40 down the sideline. And McIntyre, with a flag down on the far side of the field, will watch it go out of bounds at the 28. So that punt, which got a good hop, and they want him to kick it again. So everybody go back to your places for another punt.
Illegal formation. More than 4 guys in the backfield. 5-yard penalty. Replay 4th down.
Okay, there's 3 rules of the kicking game.
Okay.
Don't be offsides, no penalties. Don't rough the kicker, and don't let the ball hit the ground if you're a returner.
2 of those 3 rules appear to be broken on that punt. There was a penalty, and the ball was allowed to hit the ground.
Yeah.
Other than that.
That was went well. Yeah, really. Just thinking.
So McIntyre will get another shot, as will Kenny Allen. Remember, it was at the 28 where it went out of bounds before. Allen, as McIntyre fields at the 40. turns upfield into Michigan territory, and McIntyre all the way down to the Michigan 44-yard line. On today's installment of Dr. Pepper's Traditions of the Game, a staple at the University of Michigan since 1898, the famous fight song, The Victors, written in November of 1898. Louis Elbel, a music student at the university, wrote the words and the music in celebration of a last-minute Michigan win over rival Chicago. That gave Michigan their first Western Conference football championship. Sponsored by Dr. Pepper, it's a tradition. Steven Montez in at quarterback for the first time, and Montez will keep and go nowhere. Maybe a yard to the 43. And Lisa Byington with an update on Sefo Lufau.
Yeah, I'm being told by Colorado that he's questionable. They took him back as we saw. I'm told there is an X-ray capability on site, so they are looking at his right ankle extensively. Also of note, Diego Gonzalez, or place kicker, he is out with an ankle injury. Chris Graham will handle the kickoffs and field goals for Colorado from here.
Boy, that is a huge loss in the kicking game. Gonzalez has been money as far as touchbacks go. Montez going up top, jump ball deflected away. Jeremy Clark on the coverage of Bryce Bobo, and a flag is down. Flag back at the line of scrimmage.
Clark had good coverage. Perfect position, used a sideline for his help. Well done.
Personal foul, hands in the face. Defense, number 99, 15 yards. Automatic first down.
That's Matt Godin, and instead of third and 10, it's first down.
Yeah, that's a tough one. There's Matt Godin right here, number 99. And he's just going to go with a power rush on the inside. He gets to the edge, and then his hands just went to the face mask. I seen worse.
You've done worse.
Absolutely.
So all the way down to the 29 now, as Colorado tries to regain the lead in this one. A back and forth affair between the Big Ten and the Pac-12. Ross, a little flea flicker as he gives it back to Montez. Going down the sideline, jump ball deflected and incomplete. He was looking for George Frazier, who does not have a catch this year. And Michigan able to stay with it and didn't give Montez a very good look to throw it into.
He had Shea Fields in the middle field wide open, but this is where it was going to go right away. Frazier had a chance. Just make the catch. The ball's right where it has to be. Montez needs a play here to pick him up, to give him a little bit of confidence. And if you're the Michigan defense, you want to just get a good rush right here and make him feel the pressure.
Remember, as Lisa mentioned, Diego Gonzalez not available for field goals. Becomes very important where Colorado is. Pressure coming, and Peppers with the sack exploding into the backfield.
Yeah, that's a great call. It's a great call, and it's attacking your protection. Because all it is, you're going to see him, he's up top. But see, he has to take here. And so the only way for him to come is for the center to get out, and the center looks the other way. And because he's handling that way, Peppers is free.
Third sack today for Michigan, 10th of the year. And Jabril Peppers doing it all. And Colorado needs to hurry. Play clock at 5. Third down and 21. Montez, nobody open. On the roll, throws. Juggled and incomplete. Demonte Thomas got in front of Shea Fields, who couldn't pull it in, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, that is not a good idea for Montez to throw it back inside across your body. Shea Fields did break back inside. Nobody, he was the only guy who was going to give him a chance, but for something like that, don't take the chance, live for another down. Ooh, should have been caught. That was pretty good coverage there, though. Got his hand inside.
Here's Alex Kinney to block, or to punt, rather, with Jabril Peppers back on fourth and 21. Bouncing to the 2 and into the end zone. Colorado ushering it across the goal line. and the touchback for Michigan. Jabril Peppers fired up. He's doing it all, helping Michigan hang on to the lead. Michigan with a three-point lead. Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington from Ann Arbor, Michigan. Beautiful afternoon for football. And Michigan from their 20-yard line, first down and 10. The give to the motion man, Chesson. And J.U. Chesson with a flag down is out of bounds at the 22-yard line. That flag thrown right in the middle of the play back at about the 23.
But defended to the edge, which is what didn't happen the last time. Devion Smith took that to the house.
Personal foul, chop block. Offense, number 67 and 52. Half the distance to the goal, it remains first down.
So a big penalty takes it back as we go back to Mike Hall in our BTN studios in Chicago.
Kevin, another update on Nebraska and Oregon. Divine Ozigbo with a nice cut and move into the end zone. Nebraska stretches their lead. They're now up in the third, 28-20.
Huskers making some noise against a top 25 non-conference foe in Lincoln. And Michigan up by three here at home. Back at the 10-yard line. First down and 20 for Wilton Spade and company. Sets up the screen to Ty Isaac. Oh, nice little head and shoulder fake. Isaac with a first down.
That last about 15 yards was on Ty Isaac. And there's a jockstrap playing right down there on the 15. I can see it from here. They faked him out pretty good. That was well done by Isaac. Here's the first. They jump it underneath. But right there, that little bounce. That gave him another 15 and a first down.
And that's movement by Josh Tupo, and once you get that guy moving forward, momentum is hard to stop.
Yeah, if you've noticed, they've gone away from the inside run game. They're trying to attack the edges.
Offside. Defense, number 58. Contact on the snapper. 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
I looked at Jim Levitt, their defensive coordinator, but they haven't been having success inside because of Tupo. He's a big, powerful man, and he's clogged things up pretty well inside today. So they've gone to the outside.
Was suspended from the program a year ago, 2 years ago. Honorable mention, all Pac-12 pick. They're happy to have it back in that middle right now. First and five of the 37. Siasi in motion. Toss play. Evans trying to turn it upfield, and he's caught from behind by Kofavalu. Kofavalu doing some nice work from behind as he's able to catch the speedy Chris Evans. Top true freshman running back in the country as far as yards gained coming into play today.
He gives them an element that they don't have, and that's outstanding speed.
Jim Harbaugh said an interesting thing about him yesterday. He said he understands his coach is his ally.
Yeah. He listens to him. Tries to get better.
Davion Smith with the carry going up the middle, and Smith close to the first down. He's got the first. Jordan Carroll on the tackle, and a rare run up the middle that moves the chains.
So what if Michigan can get past the front line? It's a big, powerful group. Tupo up front anchors that whole thing, but their linebackers are little. They're fast but small. So if you can get a body on those guys, that's where you can make some money.
Smith plows forward to the 47. He gets four. Olabode on the stop.
So this Michigan offensive line has had almost three full quarters of understanding what they're going against. And so what they're doing right now is it looks like they're running at a bubble, and a bubble is where an offensive lineman is uncovered, and that's who a linebacker has to be able to step up.
Second and six. Spate under pressure, and Spate is sacked. Huge sack from Samson Kofavalu just when Michigan was starting to get some momentum. Kofavalu comes up with the sack.
Yeah, that's a huge play by Kofavalu. And part of it was he just beat him quick. He, you know, nobody actually didn't really touch him. He got to the top side. Coppavallo just took, you know, he looked like he was looking to butt back inside. He's going to set up this third down.
A third and 14 after the sack. Spate on the move, throwing on the run. He finds his man open. It's Perry. And Perry turned it on the Jets. Trying to race to the end zone. Caught inside the 10. First and goal, Michigan.
Good initial coverage. And his feet, the difference in the play was Spate with his feet. And he bought time, and it opened it up. It forced the defender to have to come out of coverage and attack him, instead of being patient and sitting back. And because of that, Perry fills the void, and it's a big play.
First and goal at the 7 now for Michigan. 54-yard pitch and catch. Smith on first down. And Smith backs his way down inside the 5 to the 3. Gouda on the stop for Colorado.
This is what Colorado didn't want to have to get into. Yeah, they wanted to be able to stay pace, keep pace with the score, and so they couldn't try to just pound the football on them. They know their up front can play. He knows their second level is a smaller group, so you just keep pounding on them. It'll eventually wear you out.
Second and goal at the 3. Ty Isaac the carry. Isaac fighting to the 2, backing close to the 1, and stopped short of the goal line by Ryan Moeller. And now third and goal. Toss play, Isaac. Ty Isaac got a block, touchdown.
They're attacking that edge yet again. And so until you have a defender to force it back inside, Nwuzie came up and kind of gave a one for one. You can't do that. You've got to make a stand and defend that grass. Defend every blade of grass on that field down there.
What a march. A Michigan march. 10 plays, 80 yards over 5 minutes off the clock. Isaac scores, and Michigan stretches the lead. Michigan once down in this game, 21-7. Starting to pull away a little bit with some Michigan power on that last drive, and now trying to make something happen. Joe Meese started out, and then Lindsey jumped in front of him and said no, and he took a knee.
Kevin, Michigan did exactly what a top five team is supposed to do. So they didn't blink.
Timeout for injured player.
Kalik Hudson down, true freshman.
Yeah.
On the field for Michigan. So,
yeah, no pads. That's not a good sign for the Buffalo fans.
Mm. Had a shoe in his hand.
Yeah, he was.
Sefo Lufau, who his last play was a 70-yard touchdown pass. Lisa Byington, does not look like Sefo Lufau is going to be back on the field today.
No, he's officially out, but I can attest to his toughness, his competitiveness. When I talked about how the training staff was looking at him, and I didn't think he was going to go back in because of the pain that I saw that he was in, he wanted to go back in. When he came out, he threw a towel over his head. He was very, very emotional. A couple of coaches came up to him, gave him a high five, gave him hugs, and said, look, kid, you did all that you could.
He's got the ice on it. Yep. It's ice it down now. I saw Cordell Stewart stand over there by him. He's been through that before.
On first down, 4 yard pickup for Lindsey before Ben Gideon drives it back. So now if you're Colorado, Matt, you're down 10. Momentum's gone against you, and you've got your redshirt freshman quarterback in the game. How do you muster a drive here?
Well, he's got to find, the play caller has to find something that's going to work for him. And if it's just running the football, it's not going to be able to get it done. You're going to just fall behind. So the intermediate pass game, if that's Montez's strength, that's what you have to go to.
Second and six. Lindsey again trying to get to the edge, and he was chased out of bounds by Delano Hill. Rashawn Gary providing the early speed to force him to the sideline.
Hey, Gary's the one who really, he may not have made the tackle, but he made the play. He forced him to go flat even longer instead of being able to get the edge. And then Hill was able to come up and force this third down. It's a relatively big third down right here for this, for Montez in this offense. They've got to get something. And the Michigan fans are giving them the old ooga booga.
Is that what that is? Is that the technical term?
I mean, if you looked it up, that's what it would say.
Third and four. Montez to the air wide of McIntyre. McIntyre was open. It would have been a first down. But Montez unable to connect and three and out.
It's interesting for a young quarterback. So the one thing, on the one hand, you want to say, you know, get the ball out quickly. And on the other hand, you want to tell him, look, don't rush yourself. You have, it's kind of a patience that you have to be able to have. And that one, he didn't exhibit that.
New foul over to help out his young teammate.
Every rep is a learning rep. If you're willing to learn.
Kinney to punt. One block today and one punt right into the back of his offensive lineman. And a flag is down, a delay of game.
Yeah.
Delay of game, kicking team. 5 yard penalty, fourth down.
I wouldn't want to rush punting to Jabril Peppers either.
I'd kick it away from him if I could. He's had bigger issues here today. He's been doing that. Pepper, heck, he's playing songs in his head. He's dancing out there.
Pepper's ranging over. It'll bounce and takes a great Colorado roll. Inside the 25 and down near the 22-yard line. Now, Jabril Peppers, our Benjamin Moore game changer. 9 tackles, 3.5 for loss, and 150 all-purpose yards.
Anything you need Jabril Peppers to do, you need him to blitz? Sure, go ahead. He'll do it. You need him to make a tackle in the run game? Fine. Want to play linebacker? Okay. How about safety? Yeah, I can do that. Want to line up outside the slot? Sure, I can do that as well. Oh, and by the way, return these punts. Oh, and I forgot. He ran him in all on the offensive side of the ball.
Isaac on first down. Trying to pick forward. Like he was fighting the crowd at the train station to get forward 3 yards to the 24. Second and 7. Play fake. Spade. Forced. Flushed. Tossed to Butt. Reversing his field. And Butt upended at the 39-yard line. He gets 15. Isaiah Oliver and Awuzie combine on the stop. And Jake Butt gets the first down.
Yeah, one of the things that has not been addressed here has been the feet of Spade. Spade has created opportunities to extend the play. He's a big kid. You don't really think of a guy like that, like he's going to be that mobile, but he's got some mobility to be able to buy some time, and that's been the difference in a lot of his throws here today.
Chesson in motion, Isaac the carry, and Isaac picks his way forward near the 44. 5-yard pickup, Tedrick Thompson with the tackle.
Yeah, they're starting to wear it out a little bit. Somebody here for Colorado is going to have to make a play. It's going to be in the fourth quarter.
Some hands on hips right now on that Colorado defense. Michigan leaning on the Buffs a little bit as we move to the fourth quarter here in Ann Arbor. Colorado once led 21-7, but Michigan flexing its formidable muscle and taking a 38-28 lead through three. Jabril Peppers leading the way for Michigan as the Wolverines try to stay unbeaten in the young season. A little more ooh in that woo with a 38-28 lead than there was if they'd done that, say, at 21-7.
Well, I remember in the first half, they were like, ugh.
Yeah.
Now they're
now
woo.
Yeah. Yeah.
Got it.
Colorado 195 yards in the first quarter, 107 since, as Michigan has opened up a 10-point lead and a second and five for the Wolverines. Play fake. Good fake by Spate. He's going to run. And Spate pounded down by Jimmy Gilbert.
Wilton Spate kept the ball.
Nicely done by Gilbert.
Good clean hit, too.
Yeah, nice hit. It wasn't so much, it was the sudden stop that made it look like it. Yeah, Spate slowed down. And Gilbert got his head in front of his shoulder tackle. Nice. I don't know why he slowed down. And he gave him his whole body.
Spate is 6'6", nearly 250 pounds. And on third and two in the gun. And Spate on third and two, diving for it. What a catch.
That was a great catch.
Amara Darbo, he had Isaiah Oliver all over him. And he pulled it in.
Let's see if the ball stays up. He has control. It can still move. That is a catch. He controlled it all the way through. Oliver's going to say, you know, the ball hit the ground, but he still had control of it. That's a good call.
And a fine play by Amara Darbo.
And good coverage. I mean, you can't get better than it. Oliver was all over him.
At the 47, Isaac on first down runs right into the pile and gets a yard to the 46. And again, Olabode was the first guy there for Colorado.
Yeah, that's one. When Ty Isaac goes back and watches that, he's going to not like that. Because he had Kalis clearing the end along the left side, and there was nobody there. So he's got to run with his eyes a little bit better on that one. He took it inside, should have gone outside. Olabode, though, he's played a pretty darn good game here today.
Chris Evans now in a tailback on second down. Evans with the carry. And Evans runs right into the arms of Josh Tupo. And a third down coming up.
It's a big third down. It's a 10-point game, and the Colorado offense has been stymied. More so that Lufau's out than anything. But defensively, they've played pretty well. They've got to be able to give themselves a chance right here.
Not in field goal range yet for Michigan.
Right.
So a big moment for Colorado. Down by 10 on the road.
Keep in mind, Spate's feet have been the difference and a lot of throws to them.
Third down. Spate to Butt. Oh. Batted away by Tedrick Thompson. Anticipated it, and on the full dive, spikes it to the turf.
There have been some great defensive plays here from this Colorado secondary today. Thompson is playing safety, and he's lined up on this one. What a great break he has. Did go for the catch. Lined up on Butt. That's just very, very good defense and sets up this fourth down.
Kenny Allen will punt it away. Jay McIntyre back for Colorado. And that'll spin into the end zone for the touchback. And the Buffs on their way out to the 20-yard line. 12:28 remaining in the fourth. Can Colorado mount a comeback with their backup quarterback? in Ann Arbor, Michigan. 12:28 to go in the fourth. And Colorado from their own 20-yard line, first down. First carry of the day from Michael Adkins. It goes nowhere because he runs right into the arms of Matt Godin, who brings him down at the 18.
Yeah, and so they're crowding the line of scrimmage. They got numbers that you've got to get out of that. You've got to have to throw the ball down the field at one point. So if you're not comfortable with Montez taking a deep shot like you were with Lufau, who was really throwing the ball well, then you got to work that intermediate game. You've got to start get this pass game doing something.
Montez, the redshirt freshman, on in relief of the injured Lufau. Montez in trouble, dancing around. He'll just throw that one away. The rush coming hot and heavy for Michigan. Could not get to Montez. Next weekend at noon, BTN will have either the Wisconsin-Michigan State battle or you'll see Michigan host Penn State. Then at 3:30, Indiana will take on Wake Forest, and in primetime, Nebraska hooks up with Northwestern next Saturday on BTN and BTN to go. Go to BTN.com tomorrow to see the complete schedule. The last two games set. Not sure what's happening at noon Eastern yet. Third down and 12. Ross in motion. Montez sets up the screen. The ball tipped and incomplete.
Yeah, he didn't even look. He was lucky there.
McCray was right there. And if he's able to pull it in, he's got six.
Yeah, it's just the situation's a little too big right now for Montez. And as the play caller, they're trying to run the football. They're stacking a line of scrimmage. They're giving you nothing to run into. He's not at the point where he can get out of it. So that's not good for the Colorado fans.
Seventh punt today for Alex Kinney. One has been blocked. One went into the backside of an offensive lineman. This low line drive fielded by Jabril Peppers. Here he goes. Jabril Peppers turning on the speed. Breaks a tackle. The cutback. Peppers headed for a touchdown.
Did I mention that he's pretty good? I don't know if we mentioned that yet.
We were subtle about it.
Yeah, just as subtle as he is.
What a play by one of the most electric players in college football this year, Jabril Peppers. 54-yard punt return for the touchdown that may have salted this one away. Kenny Allen with the extra point. 45-28. Michigan now by 17 in a game they trail by 14, and a BTN standout, really standing out, Jabril Peppers. 54 yards for six. Peppers electrifying the crowd in Ann Arbor. Play. Jabril Peppers got him out of their seats a moment ago. A career-long 54-yard punt return. He's also got a career-high 9 tackles this afternoon. Joel Meese from the 5. Trying to do his best Jabril Peppers impersonation. Gets to the edge and shoved out at the 36-yard line as we check in with our BTN studios in Chicago, where Mike Hall will be.
Kevin, Nebraska was up 8, but they've given up 2 straight touchdowns to Oregon. A weird storyline in this game. Oregon has gone for 2 on all 5 of their touchdowns. They have failed on 4 of those 5, so their lead is 32-28.
So they made 1, but it could be 35-28 had they just kicked the traditional extra point each time. Did math in my head.
Yeah, you should that's be, really good to you should, put your shoes back on.
Yeah, exactly. You should be impressed. So now Colorado down 17 with 11:20 to go. Takes over at their 36 first down. Montez on for the injured Sefo Lufau. Here's Adkins trying to get to the edge. He won't get there. Stopped at the 34. Rashawn Gary out there again to make the play.
They're not running directly at him, so they're trying to get the edge, and they're just playing him lateral. So here's what's happened in this football game is simple. Let's see if Alufau left with the lead. He left with their hope. Right now, they can't do anything offensively, and defensively, it's caught up with them. They needed some points at their back, and right now they're being dictated to.
Lufau's final play, a 70-yard touchdown pass, designed quarterback run for Montez, who has lost his helmet. He's got to leave the game now for a play, and that means on third down, Jordan Gerke will come in. So instead of opting to use the timeout and save Montez, here comes Jordan Gerke, a senior from Scottsdale, Arizona, who played in three games a year ago and has gone 1 for 3 for 14 yards this year. And he comes in on third down and 2 for Colorado.
All he has to do is go 1 for 1. They need something. They need a first down here because Michigan is feeling it.
0 for 10 on third down today. Gerke to throw, swing pass, caught by Adkins, and he's short of the first down. Mike McCray, the reason he's short by a yard. Fourth down and 1. You've got your backup quarterback in the game. You're down 17. The answer is yes.
Yeah, this game's going to get away from you fast. If they punt it, they haven't shown they could stop them. You may as well try to get it. Get something here.
So now Montez back out there. Fourth down. Play action. Gary with the pressure, and he can't pull it in. Sean Irwin unable to make the catch, and Michigan turns Colorado away.
That's on Montez. Yeah, he rushed himself. Remember I said you have to go. Get rid of the ball quickly, but you have to have patience when you're doing it. You can't speed yourself up. And so that's exactly what he did. And by speeding himself up, he misses Irwin, he's beat the coverage, just put the ball where it has to be, and it's a first down.
Montez 0 for 6 and unhappy with this one. 9:39 to go, and Michigan back to work. Isaac. Not much running room that time. Kafavalu right there.
And Tupo again, big number 58. Kafavalu's played a good game here today.
Michigan trying to punch this one in and go over the 50-point mark. It'll be the first time since 1903 if Michigan's able to top 50 for a third straight game. It came in averaging 57 points per game. Second and 10. Evans on the toss. Evans.
You can't do that.
Out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Witherspoon chased him out.
Yeah, I'm gonna show you something. This is not good defense. Okay, so I want you to watch the corner down here. That's what I want you to see. When you're a corner, you have to attack this and you have to force it back inside. You don't back up and give him an ole. That, my friend, is not good football. Thompson's played pretty good here, but that wasn't one of his better plays.
Pressure up the middle. Spate using his legs again. Buys time. Gets the first down to Butt. Down to the 28-yard line. And as Wilton Spate has gotten better and better throughout the day, it's been his legs that have led to some big plays.
That's exactly right. And you know, like Wilton Spate told us yesterday, Jake Butt tells him he's open on every play. So if you buy some time, just, you know, I'll be open, just find me. And he has been. You know, there are some guys in the huddle that they just, you know, they get the play and that's it. And there's other guys who are like, hey, I'll be open in this one. Just don't forget me. Hey, buddy.
From the 28, first down. Isaac the carry. Isaac the corner. And out at the 22 as we go downstairs to Lisa.
A good day for Michigan and a good day for the honorary captain, Tom Brady, who yesterday was throwing a little pitch and catch with his son, his nine-year-old Jack. I asked Jack, you know, I talked to him at the in the pregame. I said, Jack, are you going to be a receiver or a quarterback? And he looked at me proudly and he said, I'm going to be a soccer player. But, you know, I talked to Tom just a little bit. He said, I love this place, the energy. This is what Michigan football should be. This is his first time back in 17 years. He never came back for any of the bye weeks.
Isaac trying to get to the edge, and Isaac down at the 22-yard line. He was not only throwing with his son yesterday, pregame, he was throwing with the head coach, Jim Harbaugh, Tom Brady.
Jim's got the gloves on.
Tom keeping loose. He's got a couple more games in the suspension before he is back on the field, and his team got a huge win last Sunday night in Arizona.
Garoppolo played well. It was good to see.
Third down and four at the 22. Spate, some backside pressure. Spate's in trouble and he's sacked. Jimmy Gilbert was sneaking around from behind, not to mention Josh Tupou in the middle, and they combine on the stop.
Now I got to tell you, this defense, I think, has acquitted themselves pretty well. Now they do have to shore up the corners. They have not done well, I should say, the edges, because the corners have played good coverage down the field. But they've gotten after this Michigan offense pretty well, that defensive front.
Kenny Allen lining up for a 44-yard try here. His long last year was 47. This from 44, and Allen's kick is no good.
Thank you very much.
So Allen will stroll back to the sideline, missing his second field goal of the day. 6:08 to go in the fourth. Michigan. Down and 10 for Colorado at their 26-yard line. Steven Montez, the redshirt freshman, on in relief of Sefo Lufau, who left with an injury after throwing a 70-yard touchdown pass that gave Colorado the lead. Pressure coming. Montez in trouble. And Montez will throw this one away as we go to Mike Hall in our BTN studios in Chicago.
Kevin, the best thing to ever come out of Kalamazoo is the Western Michigan Broncos. They are owning the rushing game against Illinois, 250-10, and they're more than doubling them up halfway through the fourth. Things are looking
rough day for Lovie Smith and Illinois at home in that one. Second and 10 from the 26-yard line. And that's movement by Jeremy Irwin, the left tackle. Little twitch.
Remember I said about wheels falling off?
False start.
Yeah.
Offense, number 76. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
Well, we've talked about it. It's been a long time since Colorado considered themselves contenders for a bowl game, for any sort of postseason work. McIntyre has been slowly building this program. 12-27 record coming in as the head coach of the Buffs, but they were 2-0 for the first time, or the second time rather, in 9 years. But without Sefo Lufau, this team struggling to get anything going as Philip Lindsay is down at the 23-yard line. That is just 50 yards rushing today for Colorado.
And what you really see is the importance of a seasoned player. The leadership that Lufau brings and the confidence that he gives the rest of the group. And when he's gone, it's a completely different team. This right here has no juice whatsoever. Lufau's in, it's got some juice.
Third down and 13. Montez under pressure again. He's sacked. Maurice Hurst able to hang on to get the sack. Fourth sack of the day for Michigan.
Yeah, he's seeing the rush. And so, in fairness to him, they're getting a rush.
You had Peppers coming up the middle, and George Frazier had to decide, do I go with Hurst, do I go with Peppers? He took Peppers.
Which he should.
And yep. Hurst finished him off.
You take the guy who can really run, and you think your quarterback's going to beat the guy who doesn't run as well.
The fourth down, Peppers back, awaiting the punt from Kinney. Hang time for Kinney Peppers with the fair catch at the 38-yard line. Today's Duluth Trading hardest working player. How about Grant Perry? A little love for the sophomore. Return the block punt for the touchdown. Scoop that one up. And then Grant Perry coming up on the receiving end of this big play. Grant Perry, our Duluth Trading hardest working player.
This Detroit guy, Brother Rice, another one of those good football schools up here in Michigan.
Cross play to Perron Higdon on the field for the first time. Higdon slips through one tackle and gets to the 46-yard line. So Higdon with his first carry gets 8 yards. Now Michigan is just going to try to lean on Colorado, Matt, and get out of here with their third win before Penn State comes to town. Penn State and Wisconsin to follow here in the Big House before Michigan has to pack their bags in the 2016 season. Five-game homestand to start the year.
This was a better game than people thought it was going to be.
McDoom. And McDoom was doomed from the start on that play back to the 41-yard line, a loss of 5. Isaiah Oliver on the stop.
So I think Michigan's going to have to look at this tape pretty closely, because when Lufau was in, this was anybody's game. And so he was able, you know, they were able to use his feet and get outside. And, you know, he made some nice throws deep. He was manipulating the safeties and getting them out of the middle. And all those things are going to have to be looked at for their game next week against Penn State. Who brings in Saquon Barkley, who had another good game.
John O'Korn, the quarterback, on the keep. And O'Korn down just shy of the 45. Rick Gamboa on the stop. And that'll bring up fourth down. For Colorado, they will hit the road next and take on Oregon as Pac-12 play begins. For the Buffaloes, a daunting task anytime, made more so by the fact that you don't have Sefo Lufau.
Yeah, exactly. I think the good news for Michigan is that Wilton Spate, he took that hit, looked like he got a little shook up. He settled right back into his game and really did I thought he played very, very well, especially buying time and finding the guys down the field.
Charge timeout, Michigan.
Michigan.
They're first.
Using the timeout with 2:26 remaining in the fourth. Coming up, our State Farm postgame report. Dave, Jerry, and Howard will get you caught up on a wild week number 3. That's all coming up following our game. Wild week number 3 with Iowa falling, Wisconsin needing a late score to squeak out a win, Penn State in a battle with Temple, Michigan and Colorado with this one, and Nebraska and Oregon. A lot of tight contests. And then, of course, tonight, Ohio State and Oklahoma, Michigan State and Notre Dame.
Yeah, that'll be two good games.
The Ohio State-Oklahoma game has been delayed by weather in Norman. So it's going to be a late start down in Norman. McIntyre at the 21-yard line. Down at the 31-yard line. Mentioned Michigan with a five-game homestand to start this season, about to go 3-0 to start that five-game homestand. But conference play begins next week with Penn State coming to town, Wisconsin to follow, then on the road at Rutgers before a week off brings Illinois in, and then, of course, the showdown on October 29th at Michigan State.
That's always a good game, regardless of records. Forget that. But it starts next week with Penn State, which is a team they should beat. And so this also was a game where it was a team they should beat. And it was, I think, a tougher game than people thought it was going to be.
On first down, they give to Kyle Evans. And Evans out across the 35 in the arms of Mike McCray. Colorado will fall to 2-1. There will be no miracle in Michigan this year for the Colorado Buffaloes.
although I did see Cordell Stewart before the game, and I think he could still throw it 75 yards.
When Lufau went down, I'm surprised they didn't try to slip him in with a jersey on. Sneak him onto the field.
Old slash.
Second down and five. Trying to fight forward for yardage as Kyle Evans brings up third down. One more look. 1994. It's one of the great plays in college football history. Unless you're a Michigan fan, then it was not a great play in college football.
Well, if you're a college fan, that's a phenomenal play. I mean, you just had to love it.
Bill McCartney, who is on hand here today, he retired at the end of that year. Cordell Stewart, of course, with the throw. Bill McCartney's grandson got into the end zone today with coach on hand. Very exciting, I'm sure, for Derek McCartney defensively to get into the end zone with his grandpa here. Third down and two. And a little bit of a crease and a fumble on the play. Ball comes out. Kyle Evans' hands and Colorado able to recover it at the 46. It'll be a first down. George Frazier on top of it. There's Bill McCartney. Longtime head coach. What a job he did at Colorado. Former Michigan assistant. Been diagnosed with late onset Alzheimer's. But is still very socially, physically fit and here on hand today. What an impact he left both in Michigan and in Colorado. And he got a warm welcome from the crowd today when he was out on the field. That'll be the final play of this ball game. And Michigan is going to win a battle. 45-28. Michigan gets the 17-point win and is now 3-0 on this young season. Jim Harbaugh, he told us yesterday, there's no better feeling in the world than right after the game when you win. He's feeling real good right now. His team's got a win. They're 3-0.
Well, I hope Lufau heals quickly, because this is a team that could make some noise out there when he's the quarterback. When he's not the quarterback, it's a completely different team. But he gave Michigan all they could handle today. I thought he took a nice step again today. This time he had to use his feet to be able to avoid some things, and he still had his eyes downfield and made big plays. I thought that was a positive sign also for the Wolverines.
Downstairs we go to Lisa.